Good morning student, welcome back in my next video class. Today I want to discuss you about the input function and related to the other functions. So let us begin with the function called input. So here you can see that the purpose of input function is to read the input from the standard input. The standard input can be it is the keyboard by default, and the general format for the input function is you will write the variable, that is the variable name, equal to input and prompt. Prompt will be the string we want to display on the screen. What you want to display onto the screen by asking the user what information you want to display to the user, that you will be writing in the form of the prompt, and that would be the string. Okay, so when you will take the value by the help of input function, it will always return the string type. Value taken by input function will always be of string type. So by default we will not be able to perform any arithmetic operation on variable. By default the value which you are going to input by the help of input function will be of string type. Therefore, we are not able to perform any arithmetic operation, as you will see in the coming slides. Just for example, you can see what was the format. The format for the input function was the variable name which I have written, afterwards the equal to, then input, and then the prompt. So this enter your marks is the prompt, input is the name of the function. This prompt should be enclosed under the small bracket, and the string must be enclosed under the quotes, single or double. Mark is the name of the variable. Whatever you are going to input in through the input function, that will be stored under the variable marks. So what you will, as soon as you will press the enter key, you will see the prompt will come and the cursor will blink over here as enter your marks, and wherever the cursor will blink, there I had enter 8080. 80 is the numeric data, but the computer will consider by default as a string because we have used the input function. If you want to check the data type of this marks, you can write the function type. Type is the name of the function to display the data type of the variables. So type and then the name of the variable I have specified here as marks. So marks will receive the value as input 80, integer value, numeric value, but by default it accepts the value as str. Str means the string value. Class str means str is the data type. Okay, so type is one of the function. This is the new for you. Type is a name of the function which is used to display the data type of the variable. So here we can see that even we are entering the value 80, but it will be treated as a string, as you can see here, and will not allow any arithmetic operations because this value is a string value, and if you want to perform any operations, any arithmetic operation, you cannot do so, as you can see in the example below. As marks equal to input, enter your marks, we have entered the marks as 80. Then marks is equal to marks into 20/100. Suppose we want to calculate the 20% of the marks. So if you will write this very expression, this is the arithmetic operation we are going to perform here. But you can see here the whole trackball, most recent call, this, that. And the main focus, main thing that you need to focus is over here is type error, unsupported operand, type s for str, and this is one of the error. Type error will be coming because this input function receives the data as a string and you cannot perform any mathematical operation, any arithmetical operations. So we have to do some alternatives for that if we want to perform on that. So we are aware that the input function will always be of a string type, but what to do if we want to be, if you want number to be entered, if you want the number to be entered, what should we do? The solution to this problem is to convert the values of input to numeric type. using the int or float function. So the input function receives a string value, and to convert the string value into integer called int or float value, we will have two function, int and float respectively. Therefore we should know how to use the int and float function. So here it is. For example, if we want to use the int function, you will write before the input function, you will write one more function, that is the int function. So you will write marks equal to int, input enter your marks. Clear? Then this 80 will now be converted into integer. As you can see in the example, we will see in the next slide how this, if you will convert it into integer, how it will be performed. The same way float function is there. We had seen just now int and float are the two function which converts the input string value which is accepted by the input function into integer and float. So float value, float function, float is used to convert the string value into the float. So as you will write for the int, in the same way you will write down for the float. One thing here you need to remember is that when you will write int function, you need to enter the value as integer, and when you have to take the float function, you need to enter the value as float. Float means the number which should have the decimal point. So whatever you will write here as a prompt, that only will be coming as an output to display the string so that the user can enter any string with the help of the input function. So whenever you will use the input function, the prompt will be coming in just next line so that you can enter the value using the input function. Input function receives the value in the form of a string. Therefore, according to our program requirement, according to our wish, we can convert it into int or float. Okay. So next topic we will see about the type casting. Many of you are knowing about the type casting. What does type casting mean? This is one of the very important topic. So Python internally changes the data type of some operands so that all operands have the same data type. Sometimes there is a situation then where you will mix the expression in different data types. Maybe one of the operands will be of a string, when maybe another operand will be of integer, so and another operand will be of float. So if there will be the intermixed expressions, then Python internally or automatically changes one data type to another data type. And this type of conversion is automatic, done by the compiler or the interpreter. So it is known as implicit conversion. Implicit means automatically converted by the compiler. Python also supports the explicit type of conversion. This explicit type of conversion is known as type casting. So the type casting, what do you mean by type casting? So type casting is nothing but to convert the data explicitly. We will be saying as it is, type casting is going on. So explicit type of conversion is known as type casting. We will see further what more you can write along with the example in the coming slides. Okay. So first of all, we will see one by one how, what is implicit conversion as well as the example, and then next we will see about the explicit conversion. In implicit type of conversion, Python automatically converts one data type to another data type. Okay, one data type can be converted into another data type automatically by the compiler is known as implicit type of conversion. This process does not need user involvement. User are not supposed to convert it. Computer automatically convert it. It is applied generally whenever differing types of intermixed in an expression so as not to lose the information. Automatically converted, and so that it will not lose the information. and there are some rules which is based on that rules implicit conversion taken place. And the rule is very simple. Python converts all operands. All operands means all the variable whichever is involved in the expressions, whichever are given in the expressions. So all the operands up to the type of the largest operand. This is the very important line regarding the implicit conversion, that all the variables up to the type of the largest operand, Python converts that. Suppose one is integer, another one is float. So float is the higher its capacity, the float data type's capacity or size is large. So integer will be converted into float automatically. We are not converted, the computer automatically convert that one, is known as implicit conversion. And this implicit conversion is also known as coercion. Sometimes the question may come, what is coercion? Give the example. So implicit conversion is known as coercion, and rest of the definitions are written over here, so you need to write. As an example, you can see num1 is one of the variable where one integer value is stored, num2 is another variable where float value is stored, and the third variable we have taken as sum where num1 plus num2 means 156 integer value variable is added with the float variable. So what will be the output? The output will be not the integer, it is the floating point. It's the output which will be coming as 171.2. When you will add these two number, you will be getting 171.2, which is the float value. So here you can see that when you want to display the type of num1, again if you want to check the data type of any variable, you will be writing type num1, print type num1. So type returns the data type whatever you have mentioned as a parameter of the type, and here it is num1. So num1 is 156 and it is the integer value. So you will be getting the output as class int. Int means integer value. Which one is the integer value? Num1. The same way, if you want to check the num2 data type, then you will be writing print type num2 and you will be getting the output as class float. Means this num2 belongs to the float value because it contains 15.2 as a value. And then if at last if you want to check the data type of sum, then you can see here the class float is coming as an output. So when class float, why it is coming? Because 171.2 is the value for this sum, so sum data type is float. So you have noticed here as two variables value is getting added over here and returns the value as 171.2. So two variables are integer and float. So when integer and float, this is the intermixed expression. Okay, so this expressions returns the value as float. So Python convert all operands up to the type of the largest operand, and largest operand here in the case of num1 and num2, which is 156 and 15.2, is float. So largest one is the float data type, so it converts the value into float. You can check it in the system too to understand. Okay, so this is what or how implicit conversion take place internally. Next we will see about the explicit conversion. Explicit conversion is known as typecasting, and the before that you had seen implicit conversion is known as coercion. Okay, so an explicit conversion is user defined conversion. User defined means the programmer or the user converts one data type into another. Okay, so explicit type conversion is user defined conversion that forces an expression to be of a specific type. Here there is no concept of lower to higher automatically will be converted. If you want to convert lower to higher, then also it can be done. If you want to specifically write the data type from converted from float to integer, that can also be done. So it is done by the user. Okay, that is why it is known as user defined conversion. So how to do the explicit conversion, this is the form how to do it. So So first of all, you will write the data type. Under the bracket, you will write expression. This expression means the expression which you want to convert or typecast it. Where data type is the data type to which the user want to typecast the expression. Suppose you have written a, and a is integer, and here you have written float, and float a, integer a is will be converting into the float. As an example, you can see here int 45.8. This is the data type and this is the expression. So here the explicit conversion is going on. So when you will write this very expression, then you will return 45. So this 45.8, the number or the expression you have provided, and you are typecasting it into integer. So this 45.8 is converted into integer as 45. Next, second example, this was the first example. The second example is float 15. So 15 is an expression, float is the data type. So this is the format for using the explicit conversion. So float 15 will, 15 is the integer value. So this integer is now converted into float. As you can see here, 15.0 is coming as an output. The third example is with the help of variable, where a equal to 10. A is the integer variable, b equal to 6.7, b is the float variable. Int b, first of all we have written int b. B is what? Float. And which data type we are going to convert? We are converting this float into integer. So we'll typecast the data type of expression as an int. So when you will take the output for a, you will be output for b, you will see that 6 is coming as an output. Now the next expression I have written in that very example as x equal to float of a. A is what? Integer. So float of a means x will assign the value as float by converting this integer 10 into float. And the expression is given. This statement will assign 10.0. Why 10.0? Because the value of a is 10. And why it is converted into 10.0? Because we are typecasting it into float. So that integer value 10 will assign 10.0 to x, because float a cast the expression's value to float value and then assigned it into the x. First of all, a is getting converted into float and then assigned into the variable x. Clear? So this were regarding the conversion. So you need to practice it about the conversion practically. And in the next class, I will tell you about how to write the expressions in Python. So till then, you revise the topic. And today I'll be sending the PDF, the in the assignment in the form of PDF. And please do it, which is important for your examinations. So for the next video, we will meet you in the next video. Till then, you revise the topic and take care. Goodbye.